He's a trendsetter, a fashion trendsetter on the PGA Tour. One of the first guys to wear the white belt. Heck, even fat guys are wearing them now. Aaron, let's start not quite at the beginning and not even with golf. Let's start with fashion, because you were one of the first out here to start wearing some unusual fashions. Now everybody else has caught up and you're looking pretty sedate these days, comparatively speaking. What was the inspiration behind some of those outfits that you wore back in the day?
I mean, I would say that the start of it was the white belt. You know, I think Jesper Harnevik and myself were like the first two to bring the white belt out. And from there you can sort of build upon the white belt. But I think that was a key ingredient.
And you had fun with it.
Oh, absolutely.
How much flack did you get in the locker room from the boys?
Oh, I had a lot. I remember back in Australia, the guys were saying, oh, my grandpa wants their pants back. I definitely got some grief, but everyone's wearing it now, so.
And that's exactly right. You were ahead of the trend.
Yeah.
You've always been a little ahead of the trend, though. You look back to 1999 at the Australian Open. You're an amateur. You're a kid. You're not supposed to win this golf tournament. And not only did you win it, you turned pro and defended it the next year. What was that like growing up that quickly in the game?
I guess growing up, my goals and everything I was setting towards was actually towards winning that Australian Open. And then I found it tough coming over here for my first year, coming over here as an amateur, playing in sponsor invitations, somewhere that I've only really seen on TV, you know, and now I'm playing with Tiger, Vijay, Davis, all these guys who I'd only seen on TV. That was a little tough, getting used to a different culture, being away from home. That was difficult. Golfing-wise, it wasn't that difficult. I think it was more just growing up as a person.
Then on an Easter Sunday, look, you can't even help but smile when you think about it.
Yeah.
First win on the PGA Tour under an incredible setting at Hilton Head. That had to be quite a moment.
I couldn't have dreamed of a better first win, to be honest. Being Easter Sunday, being a Christian, being there with Rochelle, and, I mean, it was just special.
And then right back the next year at the Waste Management. That was a fun week too. There were a lot of people that had a chance to win that golf tournament.
Yeah, absolutely. And being at home, because I live in Scottsdale now, and I had like 100 people coming out, friends and family that were there. And my wife's from Scottsdale, so everyone who knew her was out. So that was pretty special.
Now that you're fully established on tour, you're almost an old veteran at this point.
It's crazy.
I know. When you look forward, what's on the horizon?
I've changed coaches the last couple of years, working back with my old coach who I grew up with, Dale Lynch. Excited about what we've been doing. I really feel that it's just on the way up, you know. I feel like I start contending for majors and just really establish as a top player in the world. That's
You still enjoy the process?
Absolutely. I mean, I love this game. You know, like, it gets frustrating at times, absolutely. But that's golf, you know?
Yes, it is. Last question. If you weren't a PGA Tour player, what would you be doing with your life?
I'd say I'd be a preacher, preaching the gospel. Yeah.
That is the good word.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Cheers.